For a few minutes, about once a month, why do NASA astronauts hold on to a spring-loaded mechanical arm that's mounted inside their spacecraft? I'll give you that one more time. For a few minutes, about once a month, why do NASA astronauts hold on to a spring-loaded mechanical arm that's mounted inside their spacecraft?
I'm quite interested in space. I don't know if I know this one, but I know they have to keep up with the exercise and stuff because of the microgravity, I think officially as it's known. So maybe this is some kind of, you know, muscle or bone strength test that they have to do every now and then to make sure they're keeping up with their health.
That was going to be my first guess.
There's a space thing that happens about once a month, which is the moon. So it has something to do with the moon. Because that's the lunar cycle is, I don't know, once a month or around that time.
Yeah, if it was physical fitness, I think it'd be a bit more than once a month.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So what we really need to think about is what the arm does.
My question is it many people that are doing this, or is this just one person? Like, when they are doing it, is everybody doing it at the same time? Because there's a thing that I might think that it is, if it is many people at the same time, which is, because I think they launch the boosters. I don't know how often they do that. And when they launch the boosters, the gravity changes, so they fling back into the spacecraft, so they have to hold on to something.
It is a lovely theory, but unfortunately, this is one astronaut at a time.
Is it like maybe just some kind of routine external maintenance? So they do an EVA where they're attached to the arm to maneuver them around the station? Or are they maintaining the arm?
The arm's only about a meter long.
So did we identify whether this was one person once a month or everybody does it once a month?
Each person once a month.
But one at a time.
I'm still going back to my monitoring physical strength theory. Mm.
It's not a bad theory, but it's not physical strength we're talking about.
So if we're potentially monitoring some characteristic of the astronaut.
Yes.
I do know that both, I think, bone density and like how tall you are. Because, like, you, I don't know if you shrink, if that's the right way to say it, but like,
yeah, the opposite. You actually expand a little in space.
Yeah. So is this to check how, like, if you are growing longer or have you changed in dimensions?
Yes, but not that dimension.
Not that dimension.
Is it something that wraps around them?
It's a mechanical spring.
It's a meter long arm.
And it's spring loaded.
Yeah. Then I'm wondering if it's like, yeah, like Carson was talking about, is it around the waist? Are you like checking if you would fit into the EVA suit? Because the EVA suits are probably very well specced for people. Then you have to check once a month, like, are you still okay? Everything looking good?
There is some fancy stuff going on with it. But to the outside, it's just a long piece of metal, I think, with some stuff on it.
But it's not grip strength.
It's not grip strength.
I guess, are we monitoring physiological attributes of the astronauts?
Yes.
Okay.
And there's one of those that it's really quite difficult to measure in space.
Wait.
Well, now, the space nerds out there will be being a bit pedantic with you on that.
Have I caused issues?
Yes. How might you measure someone's mass in space? Because the weight is almost zero.
It would be like a balance or something, right? Like, if you balance it on a pendulum or something, right? You know, like, when you use the... I don't remember what they're called. You know, you move the weights on the end of the beam. Is mm-hmm. the spring performing some kind of function like that?
Yeah, I think I'll give you that. This is the Space Linear Acceleration Mass Measurement Device, which is SLAMD. It's a short mechanical arm with a spring and a movement sensor. So they're not standing up. They're just kind of floating. They hold onto the arm. They release the spring. And there's a set amount of force applied to the arm. So it pulls them forward, and the speed at which they're pulled can be worked out to be their mass.
But isn't there also like how they measure the kilogram on Earth? Is because the microgravity is different. So there's kind of the measurement device on Earth is also kind of special, I think.
I thought recently they switched to a physical standard. Like there's a ball with a certain number of, I think, cesium atoms.
Oh, no, the opposite. They just switched away from a physical standard.
Yeah, because that's the thing I was thinking about. There's a machine. So there's probably something in that machine instead of thinking about, dealing with that kind of issues.
Yeah. These days it's based on Planck's constant and a very, very precise electrically controlled balance. The physics of it, I cannot remember exactly, despite once doing a video on it. But these days, yes, it is based on Planck's constant rather than a physical thing. But in the same way, force, mass, acceleration are all combined. NASA astronauts can have the equivalent of standing on a scale by grabbing onto a bar, releasing a spring, and seeing how fast it pulls them. The Lateral book is out now. Just click on the link to get your copy.